Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Crack It Online. So in the last lecture I discussed about the reciprocating pump, and in this lecture I will be dealing with the centrifugal pump. So in this lecture will be also more about numerical portion, and last around 9 to 10 year questions related with this topic I will be discussing in this video. So let's start. This video will be presented by me. You can read it here more about me. So this is the centrifugal pump. If you know that centrifugal pump has one impeller which is at the central part, so water enters into the impeller area with the centrifugal force and it discharges from this outlet. So because of this centrifugal force, it is known as the centrifugal pump, and the centrifugal pump gets strike from any prime mover. This may be any engine or this may be tractor PTO. So this is a theory about some centrifugal pump. Here more clearly you can see this is the pump area where this is the outer casing is impeller, and this is the suction pipe from where the water gets sucked into the pump by the centrifugal force and it goes into the outlet. So in the centrifugal pump you need to understand two concepts. First is the concept of specific speed and second is the affinity law, which I will be dealing in upcoming slides. So first we will see the specific speed. So what is specific speed? You just remember this formula, Ns equal to n root q h to the power 3 by 4, where q is the flow rate in meter per second and h is the head per stage. This is important. H is the head per stage in meter and n is the rpm of pump. Okay, so let's move ahead. This is the question related to specific speed. Please pause the video and read the question first, and please be seated with one pen and paper with you. So how you will solve this question? It is asking the specific speed. You need to directly apply this formula where all things have been given. See, this is a three stage centrifugal pump and this is the h per stage. So what is the total state? 36 divided by 3, because you need head per stage and it is a three stage pump. So all other data has been given. Value of n is 1400, value of q is 2400 into 10 to power minus 3 divided by 60. So this will become in meter cube per second. So this value you have to put in place of q, and h value will be 12 meter. So your value of ns will come as, please calculate this value and tell me what is the value of ns. I think it will come as option B, that is 44.67. Please verify this answer also. So let's see 2017 question. See how this same type of question repeat year by year. Here in place of 3 stage it is 6 stage. RPM value has been given and discharge has been given. What you need to do, in this case you need to put the discharge same 120 liter per second multiplied by value of RPM, that is 1450, and divided by your head per stage. So total head is 510, so divided by 6 because it is 6 stage, and hold to the power 0.75. So here see, so your answer will come as, please calculate this answer and tell me what is the value of answer. It will come around 567.41. So see, here it is also question number 39 and here also it is question number 39. So same type of question with same question number it repeats. So this is how the previous year question helps you. Okay, so let's move towards the other question. It is 2014 question. This has been also the same type of question. Here it has been given as a single stage, so no need to change anything. You directly put the values in given formula and you will get answer. Okay, so I think the specific speed concept is clear now. Now we will move towards the affinity laws. What are affinity laws? Affinity law is if relation between diameter of impeller and the RPM is changing, then what is the effect of this change on the discharge, on the head and on the power. So this has been defined using the affinity's law. So you remember this relation, these are very useful relation. So here discharge will be directly proportional to diameter. If here n is equal to constant, and in this case the diameter of impeller is equal to constant, so discharge is directly proportional to diameter, head is diameter square and power is diameter cube, and same with the RPM also. And what if both are changing? If both are changing, then this is the relation. So you need to remember this relation also. This is the diameter to the 5 and RPM to the power cube. Okay, and head is d square n square. Okay, and the discharge is d cube n. So you will be using this type of relationship to solve the problem. These are very important to remember. Please remember this much information. So let's move toward the 2010 question. Please pause the video and read the question. So in this question, what they are asking, this question will be looking very bulky and difficult to solve, but using affinity law you can simply solve this question. Very few data will be used to solve this question. They are asking the impeller diameter with respect to the head. Head is changing from 60. So what is the relation? Head is proportional to d square. So head is changing from 60 to 50. Okay. So what will be your for 60 head, what is the diameter of impeller? That has been given as 0.26 whole square and divided by d square. So you need to calculate this d. So what will be your answer? You just solve, answer will come as 0.24. So this is how affinity laws are very easy to understand, easy to solve, and question comes here from here. So let's see some other question. This is 2013 question, and here also what they are asking, they are asking about the head in meter, and with respect to what? With respect to RPM, what is the change in head? So you know the formula here, head with respect to RPM, that is the square relationship. So what is the head? Head is 12. Okay, so how you will solve this question? Head is 17 divided by, why 17? Because total head is 12 plus 5, that is 17 divided by, you need to calculate head. So what is RPM with respect to 17? That has been given as 1450. So head is RPM square, because head is directly proportional to d square and e square. So in this case d is constant and head with respect to h is 1650. It has been given in question here, 1650. So what will be your answer? 22.01. So this is how you have to apply this affinity's law. Let's see one another question. Here what is going on? Here power is changing with respect to diameter. So how, what is the change? Power is changing with respect to diameter. So you need to apply this relationship with d to the power 3. So what will be your answer? This will become as 1.36. Okay, you solve this problem using this relationship only. So for one power diameter has been given, for other power you have to, for other power you have to find it using this diameter. So see the 2016 question. This question is somewhat different. So I hope your affinity law and specific speed law concept is clear. So this question is not specifically from the centrifugal pump. Some important concept of fluid mechanics is also required to solve this question. So I hope you know the formula for head loss due to friction. That is also known as the Darcy law, 4FLV² divided by D into 2G. Okay. So you need to calculate the head loss due to friction here in meter. So this 4F is the friction factor. Friction factor directly has been given as 0.03. And what is the F? F is the coefficient of friction. And when you multiply it by 4, this is known as the coefficient. This is known as the friction factor. So here they have directly given the value of 4L. What is the value of L? L has been given as 200 meter long. What is the value of V? V has not been given. Okay. So what is the value of D? That is the diameter. It has been given as 100 mm. Value of G? You know that is the acceleration due to gravity 9.81. So how to calculate value of V? V I can calculate using discharge equal to area into velocity. Area has been given. I can calculate area using pi by 4 d square. Okay, so I need to calculate V. Discharge has been given. Yes, it is 25 liter per second. So multiplied by 10 to the power minus 3. So it will become meter cube per second. So value of V, how much it will come? It will come as 3.185. So now I know the value of V. Put value of V here. So HF will become as 31.017. So what are the other losses? Other losses are 1 meter. So add this 1 meter here. And any other losses? Delivery head is 10 meter. So add this 10 meter also. Okay. So what will be the total value? 42.017. What they are asking? They are asking the pump pressure. So what is the pressure? If you want to calculate pressure from this head, that will be rho g h. And what is the value of rho? If nothing has been given, you take the value of density as density of water, that is 10 to power 3. Value of g, even the 6th class student knows. And the value of h you have already calculated. So put this value here. So what will be the your answer in kilopascal? It will come as 412.2. This is the answer. Okay, so here the centrifugal pump question has been mixed with the fluid mechanics question. So here you need to find out the total head loss, or what is the value of total head that pump is required to deliver, and using that head you are calculating the pump power. So with this video, no question will come out from this video regarding the affinity law and the specific speed. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video. In the next video also I will take some other numerical problem which are related to pump only. And by these three video, that is, one is reciprocating pump, second is centrifugal pump, and the third is miscellaneous problem related to pump, you will be able to solve each and every problem related with pump. And here in this video also you saw already that year by year question is coming from this topic. So please do like and share, subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching.